This episode was proudly made possible by the all-new 2015 Subaru Legacy. It's not just a sedan, it's a Subaru. Can you see everything on this screen without moving your eyes? Look at me. Did you see that? Didn't think so. Thanks for tuning into DNews, I'm Trace. Eyes are little 1-inch diameter balls tucked in your head, and though they're magnificent, human eyes aren't even close to the best in the animal kingdom. In fact, your brain is tricking you into thinking your eye is seeing things that aren't there right now. We've all got blind spots that we can't see, and huge sections of our vision are just plain wrong. Take a piece of paper with a dot and a plus on it. Close one eye. Hold the paper close to your face and look straight at the dot. Pull it away slowly. Eventually, the plus should disappear. That's where your blind spot is. If you switch eyes, the dot should disappear. You might have to try it a couple of times to get it right, but to understand why this happens, we have to go inside the eye. If you could fly in through the pupil into the eyeball and look around, you would be floating in vitreous humor of the inner eye. It's a clear gel-like material. On the walls of the eye, you'd see blood vessels streaming everywhere. And spread across the back wall, you'd see the rod and cone cells of the retina. Rods are for low light, cones are for color and visual detail. If you got closer to the retina, you could spot the macula right in the middle with only cone cells. That's the only part of your vision that you can see clearly, 20/20 if you have perfect vision. If you look at my face here, you can see this clearly. But while you're looking at my face, pay attention to the walls around me, or my shirt. It's very difficult to comprehend the rest of this visual field. The macula is the only true point of visual clarity. From there, you could follow the nerves of the retina, like following a bunch of extension cords to the wall. Eventually, you'd get to the optic disc. That's the part of the eye with no rods or cones. That's where the optic nerve enters into the eyeball. It's kind of like where your eye plugs in. And it causes a blind spot. There's nothing there for the eye to perceive since there are no rod or cone cells. My eye doctor was nice enough to send me a picture of the inside of my own eyeball, so you can see the macula right there and the optic nerve right there. That's my point of clarity and my blind spot. Pretty cool, right? You just saw the inside of my eyeball. If it seems stupid to have a blind spot, you're absolutely right, it is pretty stupid. Cephalopods don't have one because their optic nerves run behind the retina rather than in front of it. Think of it this way. Cephalopods installed the wiring inside of their walls. But because of an unfortunate evolutionary mutation, mammals didn't do that, and thus we all have blind spots. The reason you don't see this blind spot all the time is because your brain fills it in. Try doing the dot and plus experiment with a piece of colorful paper, and your brain will fill it in with that color. That's your brain tricking you into thinking your vision is perfect when it's really not. Silly brain, tricks are for non-scientists. Blind spots are very important to be aware of, especially when you're driving. That's why we want to thank Subaru for making this episode possible, and especially the all-new 2015 Subaru Legacy. Every sedan has its benefits, but only one combines them all. It's not just a sedan, it's a Subaru. If you could have the eyes of another animal, which would it be? Cats, eagles, cephalopods, mantis, shrimp? We are watching for your comments, so leave one. Thanks for watching DNews, everybody. Here's looking at you, kid. Please subscribe.